Welcome to this session on how to test desktop applications in JMeter. We are going to go very basic and we will learn why to performance test a desktop application and what are the steps to test a desktop applications with JMeter. Let's get started and let us see why to load test a desktop application. So desktop applications are the client-side applications and these are the apps which are installed on your system and these are mostly used by a single user. And if that is true, then why should we load test a desktop application? So let us see the scenario. Here, the desktop application is the client-side application and we are interacting with the front end of the application, but there should be a back end of the application where the application is interacting with some server or some database at the back end. And it follows the normal client and server concept where the application will send some request and will receive back some response from the server or the database. Now in this case, for the user or for the desktop application, there will be a single backend which may be a single server or a group of servers, but for the backend there can be multiple users. So at the same time there can be multiple users interacting with the backend. So when we say performance testing of a desktop application, what we are exactly interested in testing is the backend interaction of the application, which comprises of the request and response going to the server and the overall performance of the backend services. So desktop applications act as a client for the backend server or database. And when we do a performance testing, we do the testing of this interaction with the database and we simulate a scenario where multiple users or multiple desktop applications are interacting with the server or the backend database. So now let us see how to test a desktop application. And as now we have seen, the correct terminology or use case should be how to load test the backend services or the database connected by a desktop application. Of course, you can follow the same steps to do a functional testing of the application, but here we will see how to do the performance testing of this interaction. So let us go to step one, which is start JMeter on your test machine. So I have already set up my JMeter and it is running. So you can also get your JMeter ready. And step number two is we have to add a template recording where we can set a port for interaction. So let us go and I'm going to this templates icon. You can also go to files and click templates and here you can get all these templates. I am selecting recording and say create. We can also do this manually, but templates give us an easy and straightforward way of creating our test plan. So now in this template we have a recording controller and we also have a HTTPS test script recorder. So here we are going to this port and here you can give any port. So I'm going to give a port 9191. Now let us go down and hit this start button and you will get this message. So it is asking us to install a certificate which is created in your JMeter's bin directory. So for the first time when you do this, there will be a certificate created in your bin directory of JMeter that you have to install in your browser in case you are going to do any HTTPS interaction. You can watch the earlier session on how to do that. I will click OK for now. And now let us go to our next step, which is configure desktop app to use JMeter's proxy or port. Now, in case you are on Mac, you can go to your network preferences pane. So I am going to my network preferences and here you can go to advanced and here go to this tab proxies and then based on your desktop application, you can set the proxy. In my case, I'm going to use a desktop application, which is this antivirus application, and I'm to test its interaction with web services. So I will be setting up web proxy and you can select the proxy as per your need. So I will click here and then we have to give a proxy server. So because my JMeter is running on the same machine, I will say localhost. And the port that we have set in our JMeter is 9191. And in case your proxy requires a username and password, you can give it here. Click OK and apply. In case you are on Windows, you can go to your settings. And here you will find the option for Network and Internet. Go here, and here you will find option for proxy. Let's go here, and then you will find this section for manual proxy setup. Make this on, and here provide the address which will be localhost, and then the port that we have used in our JMeter, and save the settings. And now finally we have to record our actions from our desktop application into JMeter. So let us see how to do that. We have already set up our proxies and we have set up our test script recorder. Now let me open my application as well here. So this is my desktop application and I am using a antivirus application for this demo, and I have already set the web server proxy. So now whatever I will do here should get recorded in this recording controller. So let us see. I'm clicking on this link and you can see it is recording all these actions here. So whatever actions I will do here which interacts with the backend server, it will get recorded here. So this is how you will be recording all your actions, and then finally you have to run and validate. So for that you can either filter out all these samples that you need and disable the others and then create a thread group, and then finally you can go to your thread group and set the load as per your requirement. So in my case I am just keeping it to 1 just to show you a demo, and then you can run it from your JMeter and you will get the results. You can validate the results, and so our test is now successful. I hope this session was very useful for you. In case you have any doubts or any questions, please do write them down in the comments section below and I will try to answer as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and keep learning.